Grade 9's, the following activity allows me to introduce my 45 degree set square, the one that has equal angles on both sides, and which basically means that these two are 45, and that 45 plus 45 gives me the 90 that I have there. It is the one that refers to on the instruction sheet. It says here that the 45 degree set square is shown below. To draw 45 degree lines accurately, it should be used with a T-square. So the T-square will have to work in tandem with your set square. So first things first, I've set up my page, and this time it's very important that you set up your page correctly. Remember, your T-square slides against the side of the board flush. And then your page you need to set up with one of these lines, preferably that top one or the bottom horizontal one. In my case, I have done so already. So what you see is a T-square firmly against the side, and that line lining up with my T-square perfectly. And I'm going to perform an operation here according to my instruction. I'm going to draw this grid lines using my set square and T-square. So how is it going to work? This set square is going to run on top of my T-square, and my T-square is going to serve as a base, but my T-square has to be kept flush against the side of my board. Otherwise, my lines are all going to be skew. So the word tandem means that these two both work together. So look what I'm going to do using my T-squares, my set square, and my pencil. I'm going to perform this operation here where I'm going to start in this corner drawing 45 degree lines like that, and I'm going to perform the opposite side to that. So I'm going to move my set square and my T-square up, and I'm going to pin both of them down like that, keeping that corner in line here. So it doesn't matter where you keep it, I can move this across until I get to that point there. Make sure that you keep both firmly, and then by using my pencil, keeping it like that, I'm going to draw lines nice and dark till there, right? There, just one strike of the line like that. And then I'm keeping my T-square as my base, and I'm moving my set square across like that until I get to that point over there, and then firmly attach my finger to this set square, and I move this down with my pencil like that there, and then I move this across to get to that point. I pin my set square down again, and from here I move and I draw the line up like that, and then I move my set square on top of my T-square to get to this point, and then I'm going to draw that down like that there. Alright, that is basically the first operation which you need to perform, moving from this side, from your left to your right. I can also use my set square like that, where a flat side, this flat side moves on top of my T-square, or I can move it like that, or I can move it like that, but never a point. Never a point. It can't be on a point because it needs to be firm onto your T-square. Now, to perform the other line starting from this top corner there, I'm going to move my set square on my T-square like that, and then I'm going to start here. So there I've performed the first task on my page as one operation. So now I'm going to look at this component here, which I want to reproduce over with my starting point there. This time I'm going to draw faint, and then afterwards I'm going to darken, and I have to measure as well. Right, so what I'm going to do first is I'm going to draw my 45 degree lines this way and that way, and then I'm going to draw that block and work out my insides. There you've concluded your second activity on this particular page that we have there. You do not have to fill in the dimensions. You can leave that out. All you need to do is to reproduce this over to that space over there. I hope you're going to enjoy it.